Today in After Effects, we are going to be taking a look at creating this kinetic type effect. As you can see, the type rotates around and switches what it says. First, we need to create a new composition. Go up to Composition and then down to New Composition. I will make my 1920 by 1080 and hit OK. The first thing we need to do to create this effect is type out some text. Go up and grab your text tool and type out some text in whatever color, size, and typeface you would like. Then center your text on the stage. After that, we need to move the orientation point of this text so that we can change where it rotates around. Go up to the toolbar and grab the Pan Behind tool. Then zoom in and drag the small crosshair to the very bottom and center of your text, right where the bounding box handle sits. After that, we will go ahead and set up our second piece of text. First, turn on your rulers by pressing Command or Control R. Then click and drag from the side ruler to create a guide. Now place guides on each side of your text so that you know where our second piece of text is going to need to fit. Also, place a horizontal guide at the bottom of your text. Lastly, turn this layer into a 3D layer by checking on the 3D layer box. If you don't see this, press the Toggle Switches and Modes button at the bottom of your window. After that, with your first layer selected, hit Ctrl-D to make a duplicate. Then turn off the original layer. Now grab your text tool again and type out the second part of your text that you want to use. Try and use text that is similar in length to the original if possible. To make the effect as seamless as possible, select your text and scale it down so that it fits within the guides that we established. Once everything is lined up, we are ready to start animating. Turn off your second text layer and then turn the first one back on. Select the first text layer and press R on your keyboard. Now set a keyframe for the X rotation by clicking the stopwatch. Then move the playhead to half a second and turn the X rotation up until your text looks as though it's falling forward. Make sure that you stop when your text gets 3/4 of the way around and is a straight, illegible line. For my text, this happened at 269 degrees. Then press Alt right square bracket to trim the first text layer to the half second mark. Then select your second layer and turn it on. Press Alt left square bracket to trim it to the half second mark with the excess continuing on. Zoom in to be sure that these do not overlap and you are instead butting them up against each other. After that, press R and set an X rotation keyframe. Make this value match the ending value of the other text layer. In my case, this was again 269 degrees. This means that this layer will be picking up right where the other left off. Then scrub to 1 second and make a keyframe where the text is right side up at 365 degrees or 1 revolution. Now we can trim our work area and hit spacebar to test and render our animation. So now that's looking pretty cool. To make it a bit better, you can select the first keyframe of text layer 1 and the last keyframe of text layer 2 and press F9 to turn them into easy ease keyframes. This will make the overall animation a bit more realistic. Feel free to tweak this animation to your liking. You can also make the text revolve around a different point, such as the left or right, for a different effect. As always, if you enjoyed this After Effects tutorial, be sure to subscribe, rate, comment, and share it with your friends.